if it had not been for the Lord, who has always been out by our side. Our enemies would have swallowed us and we would have drowned in their waters. But our souls have found an escape because our hiding place is in you. The fowler's snare has been broken and we are joyous. We are free and we are kept in the shadow of his wings. We honor you, Holy Spirit. We honor your presence. We release the praise unto you. It is the least we can do. Hallelujah. Let's take our seats, saints. Amen. Let's honor our praise team as they also take their seats. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please say hello to a neighbor. Just shake somebody's hand. They may have arrived late. Give them a compliment. If they look sharp, tell them you look sharp. Hallelujah. Say hello to someone. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm a child of God, and my name is Pastor Zotile. Amen. I'm a daughter in this house. Hallelujah. I would like to honor the presence of all leadership and all protocol observed. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I plan to finish on time in Jesus' name. I just want to also emphasize a few things, Bazalwane. Thank you so much to Womage. Pastor Ebere on Thursday said the church was a ghost town. There was no one here. And that tells us the women in this church are the nexus of the church. Amen. Because we were less than 20 or so. We're 25 or so. The women realized when the women are not here, it means everyone else is generally not here. We want to say thank you to Womage. Thank you to Womage. By faith, Babe, I will not be hurt because they didn't arrive on your day. I will take it by faith because they were running late and they were still going to arrive late because they were not here. So by faith, they were meant to be there. Amen. We want to honor the women. Bazalwane, thank you, because we saw what things are a bit different. Amen. Please clap hands for yourselves. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you so much. Bazalwane, I am so happy today. The Holy Spirit was confirming a few things. Babe was speaking about Nehemiah 4. And today's scripture is going to be based on Nehemiah as well. Nehemiah 8. And that's why I stood up there, because something was quickened in my spirit. Amen. On Monday, Pastor Nomcebo led prayer. And Holy Spirit led her to speak about the joy of the Lord. So this morning, I was conflicted how to relay the message. But by God's grace, it will consolidate in Jesus' name. It will come together. Hallelujah. There is something Babe has been ministering to us, for those of you who may not have been here for a while. Babe has been ministering to us on the hindrances, things that hinder us from being able to glorify God in all spheres of our lives. Amen. And he spoke of things like idolatry, things like homosexuality, things like rage, things, so many things in Colossians. That was where the scripture was based. And there was something he said that to me stuck. It is based on Ephesians 5, 26-27, where it says, and previously you were these people who would not enjoy the kingdom of God. Previously, you were in this group, but now you have been justified, you have been washed, you've been sanctified, amen. Through the washing of the water, through the word. And I thought, hi. There's a secret there. There is a secret there. Because if we are going to meet our Father in heaven, if we are going to inherit the kingdom of God, we need to allow the word to wash us. We need to allow the word to wash things off. Utsababe, in that other service 2 weeks ago, the things are being shaken off through the power of the word, which washes these things off. Amen. And you and I know we do not wash once a week. We wash daily for a reason. And the word is there to wash us daily of these things,
just to make sure we meet our Father. Hallelujah. Amen. And just in case you've forgotten, I like amen. Amen is important for God. So please don't withhold your amen. It belongs to God. Amen. Hallelujah. And I was also seriously convicted when Mareno Mqebe preached on the joy of the Lord. There is a mystery, Bazalwane, on being joyous in the Lord. And being joyous in the Lord comes from eating of the word. Because this world can't give us joy. This world has no joy to give us. This world will only give us momentary things, temporary things. But in the word, we are able to receive joy in the word. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And the Hebrew word for joy is simha. The H is the C there is silent. It's simha. And when Mareno Mqebe was ministering on Monday, I thought to myself, this thing of having joy in the Lord is a mystery. Because this verse was not dependent on how you are feeling. It's not dependent on what you are going through. It's not dependent on if you've got money or not, if you've got food or not. But this verse, hence it's in the Nehemiah, because I had to go and read what was the context of this thing of saying we find our joy is in the Lord. Our strength is in the joy of the Lord. I thought, I want to understand this thing, Bazalwane. I would like us, please, in the interest of time, please beam for us Nehemiah 8 from verse 1 to 11. We are going to read it. And then I just want to introduce to us the context, why that word was being read, what the word meant at that time. Let us read. I will ask that we do it loudly together so we save time. So Nehemiah 8, 1 to 11. Amen. Let us read together. All the people came together as one in the square before the water gate. They told Ezra, the teacher of the law, to bring out the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded for Israel. So on the first day of the seventh month, Ezra the priest brought the law before the assembly, which was made up of men and women, all who were able to understand. He read it aloud from daybreak till noon as he faced the square before the water gate in the presence of the men, women, and others who could understand. And all the people listened attentively to the book of the law. Ezra, the teacher of the law, stood on a high wooden platform built for the occasion. Beside him on his right stood Mattithiah, Shema, Ananiah, Uriah, Hilkiah, and Maaseiah. And on his left were Padiah, Mishael, Malkiah, Hashum, Hashbadana, Zechariah, and Meshulam. Ezra opened the book. All the people could see him because he was standing above them. And as he opened it, the people all stood up. Ezra praised the Lord, the great God, and all the people lifted their hands and responded, Amen, Amen. Then they bowed down and worshiped the Lord with their faces to the ground. The Levites, Jeshua, Bani, Sherebiah, Jamin, Akub, Shabbatai, Hodiah, Maaseiah, Kelita, Azariah, Josabad, Hanan, and Paleah instructed the people in the law while the people were standing there. They read from the book of the law of God, making it clear and giving the meaning so that the people understood what was being read. Then Nehemiah the governor, Ezra the priest and teacher of the law, and the Levites who were instructing the people said to them all, "This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep." For all the people had been weeping as they listened to the words of the law. Nehemiah said, Go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is holy to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. Amen. This scripture was read to a people who were not happy. This scripture was read to a generation of people who had learned the art of being disloyal to God. This word was read to a generation who had forgotten who they were in Christ. This word was read to a generation of people who had made idolatry their default position. When Nehemiah came to rebuild the walls, in my spirit I had a revelation, because Nehemiah wasn't just going to rebuild the walls of Israel. He had gone to rebuild the walls around their hearts. Because the issue of salvation, the issue of Christ, begins in the heart. And their hearts were no longer with God. They had only heard of the great miracles of Moses and Jacob as a story. They no longer believed these things had happened. These people believed their grandfathers were great men of God who had experienced the Father, who had an encounter, but they did not have a personal encounter. So the breaking down of the walls was a physical representation of what had happened here. Hallelujah. The walls had to be rebuilt because lange khathi, the walls to keep out the enemy here were gone. The walls to keep out idolatry and sin were broken down in their hearts. Hallelujah. Amen. So when Ezra was rebuilding the physical walls, lange khathi, God wanted to rebuild their walls to say, keep me inside and me alone. Let no one else have a place. Lange khathi kuwe. Hallelujah. And that is why in the scripture, it is said, as the book of the law was being read, they immediately stood up. Meaning, but they stood up because their spirits were quickened, because God said, hallelujah. They had not heard the word in a long time. It had not spoken to them in a long time. And in verse 6, we are told, and when they heard the book of the law, they responded and they said, amen, amen. And if you notice there, no one was going within them row by row and encouraging them. As the word was read, Holy Spirit descended and he did the work among them. And individually, each one said, amen, hallelujah. So this word is being read for a people who are far away from God. This word is being read for Bantu who are in the midst of the priests. That is why you are reading about Joshaban, Hani, Jeshua, so and so, because it is saying to you, there was a structure there. There was a priesthood, lebeikona. There were men and women of God ministering to them. Hallelujah. That's why it was important to see who was there. Because it shows the systems were there. Hallelujah. Say, systems were there. In this local church, systems are here, bazalwane. But it's possible, even when the systems are there, we are not there. Gendega, there are pastors there, there are administrators there, there are worshippers there, but we are not there. And that is why at the end, look at verse 11, then Nehemiah must say, do not weep. Because as the book of the law was being read, Holy Spirit was convicting them one by one. He was saying, Mage Chima, you're in the wrong place. Mage Bateli, you look warm. So and so, you've forgotten your place. Amen. There was a hindrance of the glory of God for that generation. And even this morning, it is possible the same is true for us. But we are within a church with systems, with pastors, with structures, worshippers like we have. And Gendega, they dispense power, and we are here, and we can't connect. We don't have an encounter. Hallelujah. And then just like them, may God rebuild our walls here. Because Lenzaba begins in the heart. This thing is into ya lanhlitweni. And that is why the word there said, Ezra stood on a high wooden platform. Hallelujah. This is a high platform. This one. This one. And power is dispensed from here. Power is dispensed from this place. And it is possible, sesikwetayele, when we come in for a register. We come in, kusibangibonile sigungwini sami. I checked in, I'm gone. When Ezra read the word from here, as they heard the word, individually, in their spirits, something said, amen. And these were people, by this time, remember, the walls are broken. Hallelujah. Their enemies could come at any time. Hallelujah. By this time, they are a people of history. Sekuthiwa, yeah, libe kwa Israeli. Sekushiwo njalo ngabe kuthi, yeah. By this time, their city was in ruins. Nothing was functional. Amen. Even small, small nations could have attacked them. Hallelujah. At this time, these people are walking downcast in their hearts. These people are discouraged in their hearts. And that is why when the word fell down, when the book of the law was read, the natural thing to do was to weep for themselves. But shame me, ne. But now Nehemiah is saying, do not weep. Show for me verse 8, I think. It says, this day is holy. Hallelujah. Go to verse 8 or 9, where it says, this day is holy. Or is it verse 10? Verse 10. Give us verse 10, please. This day is holy to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. This day is holy. This Sunday is holy. This morning is holy. Do not grieve, because the joy of the Lord is your strength. The walls around you, you live in a generation of godless people. We live in a generation of people who think having God in your life is an optional thing. As though there's anything better. And the word says today, this day is holy. Because with whatever is happening, Magam Sibi, on this day, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Amen. And that is when my spirit, I said, Lord, that word cleansed that generation. That word was enough. Ubakeza. And they realize in their minds, as Nehemiah is building the walls of the city, may I begin with the walls in my heart. Hallelujah. Because a wall is meant to keep your enemies out. And it's meant to protect your assets within. Walls are meant to keep thieves outside your boundary. But it's meant to protect what you already have. And we have the power of the gospel. Bazalwane. We have salvation, Tine. And the walls here must be rebuilt. That is why, Bazalwane, I love the song that says, Dambule, Kulenzao. And my revelation means, we're about to sing it now, praise team was. When we sing it, we say, Dambule, Kulenzao, meaning either mbak, or either meaning mbabane. But for me, I say, Ngos, Dambule la. La. Because it's possible to be in a Mbabane church like this one. To be blessed like we are. But if the revelation has not come in my heart, I am wasting time. So when we say dambule, I pray when you say dambule ngosila. Because for that generation, kwakufuna dambule lana. So that as Tobias and Sanballat were coming for them, Nehemiah at some stage says, you have no portion in Israel. You have no power here. You have no authority here. You are nameless here among the house of Israel. Because our God has revealed himself here first. The things he did of old with our forefathers, he can still do with us in the city, but he must begin here. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Let us start, Bazalwan. We're going to sing this song. And may it be a prayer for you to say, Dambule, Kulenzao, come down in power here. So that when, as things are happening, the word must wash my heart first. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. Amen.
Dambule.
Thank you, Lord.
Gimi nkosi. Vela ngamandla akho. Baba dambule. Gimi nkosi. Vela ngamandla akho dambule gimi
ngole
gimi nkosi
nkosi
vela ngamandla dambule njalo njalo gimi nkosi
whatever we are doing, because we cannot attract his blessings, his glory. Nangabe lenhlitiyo is not complying and responding accordingly. And the word, Bazalwane, is meant to cleanse us of every filthy thing that opposes the power of the word in our hearts. the word, when it comes down, is meant to break down every barrier that resists his power. When the word is washing us, some of us, the word must just humble us. Some of us, the word must come and remove you from your own pulpit, and you come down to allow God to be God. And there are things that are hindering us. Sin is hindering us. Rage, anger, unforgiveness, bitterness, grudges. But the word, sikezo. And we must allow the word to flow in us. I lam back on a Sunday. The word must wash us. So we come, when we come here, we come in one accord. Now lem 17 ga works. The word must have washed you there. The word is powerful, ebazalwane. The word is mighty. It must wash us. Loku sihleli lapha nje. Kukhona labangakavuselani lana mabomu. There are people we do not relate with la. Same skungu. Sometimes the same committees. Sometimes we're in the same families. We are related by blood, by marriage. And we convene together in a local church. What kind of word is this that can't wash the things between us? What kind of word is this? What kind of word is this, ebazalwane? Lele lisiyekelako, singavuselani, singangoba ngisho ukungcwabana. Sikholwa. What kind of a word is this? Things are hindering the manifestation of God's glory in our personal lives, not even as a church. And the word of God wants to wash these things between us. Wash to wash me. Hallelujah. One thing the word will do, which you must remember, because now we are going to worship God genuinely and pray for mercy. One thing the word will do, when the word washes you, one of the first things it will do, it will cause you, it will push you to worship God. One of the first things, when you read the word, it pushes you to worship God. That is why in this scripture, like verse 7, it says, they were filled with awe because they had heard of this God. They had stories about him, but the minute the book of the law was read, in their hearts, they felt him. He is mighty. He is worthy. And I want to worship him. Because, bazalwane, we need to come to a point, lakona, worship is not a program issue in the day. No. Kungabe kuthi praise team in 30 minutes to lead them. No. You are coming already, you are worshiping. As they lead us, you are connecting. And even if they stop singing, in your heart, you are still in awe of this God. You are still worshiping him, because worship is not only music. Worship is a lifestyle. Worship is a lifestyle, ebazalwane. That is what we are being called to in the last days. Because uyabuya, there's no more time. Uyabuya. And that generation, just like ours, kushiwo njalo. When the word descends, it just propels you to say bayete. Uyingwele. Wala unganalutho. When you have nothing in your fridge, nothing in your account, but your inside agrees to say all hail to the King. The second thing the word will do, the washing of the word will cause, it will quicken your spirit. We had a night prayer 2 weeks ago, Baba was ministering. And I just want to encourage the church, Ebazalwane. Prayer works. Prayer works. And there's some things the ministers, when they're here, they will say them. Bendlula. kanti it is a word or something serious to pray about. In that prayer, Babe said, the body of Christ has fallen asleep. Umtimba wa Kristu sowulele. The body of Christ, who is the bride of Christ? And this man is come back to fetch a whole bride, a washed, sanctified, unblemished bride who must be awake. And the church has fallen asleep. That thing pierced my heart. Ngoba ngathi ngosi mine, ngisho mine mine, I am asleep. There are areas in my prayer life where I am asleep. There are things happening in my family because ngimlolele. There are things happening in my country, in my company, where I work, in my city, Mbabane, because I am asleep. If God could fetch one man, Nehemiah, from a palace and say, go to those people who have given up on themselves, it is because he was saying, you must come here to wake them up. So the word of God comes to quicken us. So lele, touch your neighbor, papama. Touch your neighbor, wake up. Seriously, touch your neighbor, wake up. Yes, the word is meant to quicken us. There are things that must happen once, this is never again. This is never again, because we are awake. And we are sleeping as a church. The enemy, ujaiva nasla bandleni la. We are a laughing stock. We are a mockery because the church has fallen asleep. And Satan, yabazalwane, is carrying yabani cot. He's just rocking us to sleep. Rocking us to sleep, bazalwane, in different ways. Silele nje. What's no problem? One of the ways he's making sure we are falling asleep, he's saying, go to church. Make sure you don't miss a Sunday. Show up and go to church. But don't have a feeling of community when you get there. He's saying, no problem. Attend every service you want. But when you get there, feel alone. When you get there, don't say hello to anybody. Don't commune with anyone. But show up. Show up for everything. That is a lullaby of the enemy. Hallelujah. It is a serious lullaby of the church today. Hallelujah. Bazalwane, the word of God comes to quicken us. Some things must happen. Thing I be normal. No. This is unscriptural. It is contrary to the word. Amen. Another thing the word will do, it will make sure you enjoy. I saw a video, where you were singing there by the altar, where the song was saying, Slalanai, Slalanai. And you said there when you were singing, when you were ministering, you said, Nimagul kuni, si Slalanai. Asasugi la. If I leave him here, where will I go? And the word does that. It says whatever is going wrong, we will stay in this relationship. Because I am in me, you live, you move, you have your being. Where will you go outside of me? The last thing that the word is able to do, the cleansing the word does, it keeps us thinking of eternity. As we are moving, as we live in the moment, as we are worshiping now, not as a ritual, as we give him the best every day, every time. Lo moya wethu says, we don't belong here. We're on transit. We are going home. We have eternity in mind. Hallelujah. And that will make us forget. This thing of there's no mbakwe we're going there. There is a bride of Christ. Finish. And maybe we are the arm and the bride of Christ, but we are sleeping. We are asleep, Pasaluan. So the word, Pasaluan, is read at home with the children. The word is read lekhaya, and it quickens you there. And when you come here, you are igniting with the rest of us. Alfun vala papela, and wait for another week until you read it. As you read the word, something Mungu says to you, wake up, papama, hallelujah. And the other thing the word will do that has been dropped in my spirit now, the other thing the word will do when it is cleansing you, it removes you as the center of attention. It removes you and I. Look at Nehemiah. Nehemiah beka pila in a palace. As far as he was concerned, the world was fine. He was a cupbearer, meaning he served his majesty. You understand the level of power he was exposed to. And Holy Spirit, because God is faithful, placed in his heart a burden for Israel. Until the king said, why do you look so sullen? Why do you look so sad? And he said, the walls in Israel have been decimated. Because God was teaching us through Nehemiah, when I use you, I will forget about you. I will use you as a vessel. When I use you, when I think, want things of the Spirit being done, poor man Leleni, you are a chisel for me to use. You are a spade for me to use. Forget about you. It is about the work. Amen. And in this house, there is work to be done. Amen. In the spiritual realm, there is work to be done. In the spiritual dimensions of Mbabane as a city, there's work to be done. In the country as Swatini, there is work to be done. And the word must cleanse us. Usuke endleleni. And be a Nehemiah who will forget themselves and the privileges you've got access to. And say, Lord, use me. Nehemiah now was being... Palabatobia were non-entities. Wasan Balat were nobodies. But he was being spat on by Wasan Balat for God. He was being ridiculed by unknown men for God. And we must come to a place where we must contend with unknown men for God. Where we must fight battles for Jesus. Because inside our God lives. Praise God. May the church rise as I invite the bishop. Babe, I know Holy Spirit has spoken to you. We trust you, Mwelas, to speak a word over us. Hallelujah. Praise team. Molongo has spoken to you equally. You are going to minister to us just before Mwelase speaks a word. He will give you the song he wants if it's been led in his spirit. Or Holy Spirit has already planted the one we need. Hallelujah. Minister unto us. And Bazolane, connect in the moment. Praise God.
Amen. Media, kindly beam Ephesians 5, verse 26 and 27. Paul is highlighting eternal truths concerning the church. When you start from verse 22, he says, we should submit to each other in the fear of the Lord. Which means if you fear the Lord, you have no choice but to submit. The question is, do you fear the Lord? Because it's easy to be religious. To fall from grace doesn't require you to to break into somebody's house. It starts in the heart. You can be in the church and be fallen from grace. You can be in the church and be far from grace. Wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands. Sorry, verse 21. Submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. That's the verse I was quoting. We submit to one another. And then Paul begins to categorize the responsibilities. He addresses husbands and says to them they should love the Lord. He addresses wives to submit to their husbands. Somewhere he says, I'm talking of a mystery. In other words, it's more than just husband and wife. This is a mystery. This is about the church. Now, get to 26. Now, when you come to verse 26, it says, what Christ is doing currently, as we are standing here, is to make us, the bride, the church, holy. The writer of Hebrews says, without holiness, no one will see the Lord. He is making us holy. He is cleansing us by the washing with water through the word. And 27. The reason he does all this, the work doesn't end here, Bazalwan, is so that we are presented to himself as a radiant church. A radiant church is a glorious church, is a glowing church. A church that reflects his glory. A church without stain. A church without wrinkle. A church without blemish, but holy and blameless. We are about to pray now. Let's stop playing church. Church is church because of the standards of Jesus. Not the standards of me or any other committee. Church is church because of the standards of the word. Let's close our eyes and pray. Allow me to pray with you. You are here. And you are saying, God, I will only pray. But your prayer is a prayer to God. God, revive me. God, awaken me. There are things I've been looking down, despising, going with the multitude, going with the crowd, going with people who are patting me at my back. But here I am today, standing before you. And when I pass from this world, I'm not going to face any other person but you. You see, this is what David said. He said, my sin is before you and before you alone. We want to pray a special prayer this morning. You are here and say, I've been slumbering. The prayer she's quoting, we were praying here. And the Holy Spirit revealed that phrase. We are sleeping. We are allowing noises to shut us from hearing God. Church, it's about God. It's not about any other person. It's about God. And we present this God to you this morning. You are saying, God, revive me. Father, awaken me from my slumber. And if you say that, come to the front as we cry to God. Awaken me from the sleep. Awaken me from the slumber. I realize I have allowed things. I have allowed people. I have allowed opinions. I have allowed feelings. I have allowed ideas. I have allowed philosophies. And I'm sidetracked. The verses we have been reading the previous week, Paul said, don't be deceived. There is deception. Even in the church, there is deception. It calls for eyes and hearts that can cry to God and say, Father, I rededicate myself to you. I rededicate myself to you. I want to pray now in the name of Jesus. I rededicate myself. Thank you. I rededicate myself. It's not about people. It's about me. I'm coming to you, oh God. I'm rededicating myself to you. I want to be alive again. I want to be alive again. I don't want to be lukewarm. I want to be hot for God. I want to hear from God. God bless you. We are praying now in the name of Jesus. Don't let this blessing pass you by, because it may be an opportunity for you to have other things broken from your life, loosened in your life, discarded in your life, dusted from your life because of his power. His anointing comes for a purpose. And don't fear people. If you are there, I am standing with this in the front. I'm saying, God, dust things from my life, because I don't want to be religious. I want to be awake. I want to be alive for God. I don't want to be lukewarm. I want to be hot. Especially these days when the trumpet is about to sound, the train is about to pull. Lord, revive me. Make me hot again. Make me alive. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this morning. Father, we thank you for speaking to us in this manner. Thank you for loving us, and you have not hidden your heart from us. You have opened yourself to make us hear, to make us understand. The theme is not just a theme. It's not just a decoration. But it is our heart's desire that we reflect you wherever you have planted us. We also realize that there are things that come our way and want to hinder your glory from being reflected. We repent this morning in the name of Jesus. We plead your blood. We plead your blood. Namasuka talabaya. Shaka talabasoko roboya. Manamazikelebeandalabasaya. We plead your blood, oh God. We say, Father, like the children of Israel, when your word is read, we want our spirits to jump, to shout amen to you, to shout glory to you. The reading of your word should not just be like a novel, should not just be like a newspaper. Oh God, Helabaya, in the name of Jesus, want it to have meaning. Holy Spirit, let your word pick and prick our hearts. Here are your people standing before you. Hear our repentant hearts. Father, have mercy upon us. in the name of Jesus. We don't want to be just a congregation. I pray for Mbabane Alliance Church. I pray for everyone represented here. We don't want to be just a congregation. We want to be a house of life in the name of Jesus. I break every force. I break every power that is working as a hindrance to hinder your glory from wherever you have planted us. Holy Spirit, hey, hover over us. Hover over our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, hover over our lives. Holy Ghost, and make us clean. Make us relevant here. And make us ready to receive and meet you in the air when rapture takes place. Continue to minister to our lives, even as we take our different place, take our different routes to our respective places in the name of Jesus. Continue to trouble each one's heart until we come on our knees and bow before you and recognize you as God in Jesus' name. We receive your word. We welcome your word in Jesus' name. We believe your word. Let it continue to work in us and work through us to the honor and glory of your name in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You may be seated. Amen. Let's appreciate Pastor Zotti. There is an English saying that fruits don't fall away from the tree. You see a tree, you see fruits. You see fruits, you see the tree that produced. Amen. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. Amen. Amen.